everything you have done, everything you're going to do, then everything you have done up to this very point. I pray that I may decrease and that you may increase. And let the people of God say a few verses of scripture. Amen. I'm going to do what thus says the Lord and get right on out of your way. Amen. The scripture is coming out of Psalms 133. Psalms 133. And I'm going to tie it into what God has given me.
Amen.
Amen. And the scripture reads as Psalms 133, verse 1. Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. How good and pleasant it is for brothers to dwell together in unity.
Amen.
If you look around in life and see the many things that are going on and the many things that are happening, most people are now unified.
All right.
See, now if you don't realize that the church have to get back to that unity that we used to have. Come on, somebody. I was always in church. I remember the tent revivals and they used to play the music and I couldn't wait to get my shout on. Why? Because when we got with the saints of God, God started stirring up something. I couldn't understand the anointing, but my feet got to moving and we used to kick up dirt in the dust in the tent. And I come out here to tell you some of the same stuff we used to do in the nightclub. Oh, you don't want to talk to me. Some of the same stuff we used to do at Palladium. Some of the same stuff we used to do at Heroes and Headlights. Come on, somebody. You better act like you know. Some of the same stuff we used to do at Oasis. But now some of us that got to church and seem like we in witness protection. But I come out here to tell you, you better learn how to let your wings back. You better learn how to take off them fingernails and take off them shoes and learn how to shout and give a praise unto God. The Bible says in the book of Nehemiah, chapter 4, verse 6, the Bible says, so we built the wall, and the people had a mind to work.
Yeah.
See, a lot of folk now don't want to work at nothing no more in the church house. That's why a lot of people are so afraid to get out of the church.
Yeah.
And some people say, well, I got church hurt. I come out here to tell you, when you get anchored in Jesus, for those that have got hurt, when you get crucified in Christ, come on, somebody, when you get your feet planted in the whole heavenly Holy Ghost, when you be like that tree that's planted by the river of water, and his leaves also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. When they're talking on the road, when they call you a fool and a fanatic, when they tell you you need to sit down and shut up, you will keep on shouting, you will keep on praising God, but they can't understand why you raising your hands. They didn't see you when you had to down the money for the rent. They didn't see you when your son was stricken with cancer, so they don't understand your praise. Unified with Christ, when you set up resident on the inside, when a revival come on the inside of your spirit, you can't help but to move. The Bible says, the people, yeah, I like the way he put it, Nehemiah, he said, for we, if you read the scripture, it said, for we, so we built the wall. See, in one hand, for those that know the story, the Bible said they had a hammer in one hand, and in the other hand, they had a sword. Oh, come on, somebody act like you know. Some of us still packing. Help the Holy Ghost. If Hollywood ever needed some actors, that they could stop by the church. The Bible says, so we built the wall. In one hand, they had a hammer.
Uh-huh.
In the other hand, they had a sword.
Yeah.
They had the hammer to do the work.
Yeah.
Because the Bible said that the walls of Jerusalem were torn down.
Yeah.
And it was going to take a special miracle.
Yeah.
And then Nehemiah, before all that even happened, if you go back to chapter 1, the Bible said, and Nehemiah prayed first.
Right.
And consulted the Lord first.
Right.
But before he even did that, the Bible said, he started confessing stuff. And said, Lord, we have went against the things that you have taught, the things that Moses have taught. See, sometimes before you start asking God to stop the refrigerator from leaking, before you start asking God to sit
Before you start asking God to give you gas money, you better learn how to confess some stuff. If a gentleman is a heterosexual, that means he's attracted to a woman.
Yes.
So women, you have to govern yourselves accordingly.
Yes.
I implore any woman that's single to read Proverbs 31.
Yes.
It'll help you prepare yourself for the husband.
Yes.
See, if you prepare yourself, that man will line up or get out. Come on, somebody. See, that's why a lot of men are doing what they're doing. Because you got too many people in the world, and you got too many people allowing these men to do what they do. Because they're attracted to you, and you know you're attracted to him, and he's attracted to you. You know there is some power, there's some friction there. So therefore, you can say what you want to say to get what you want. You can say, but no, baby, not right now. And the average man that really like you, he'll wait. His legs may be bobbing, but he'll wait. He may be nervous, but he'll wait. He may be sweating, but he'll wait. You may want to ruin your bed, but he'll wait. Why? Because this is a treasure on the inside. That's unity, sex. That's unity. Me and my sister, we built the wall. And walls in the Bible. Walls represent protection. It was a defense. Because if you didn't have walls and the enemy heard him, he'll invade it. He'll come right on in. I'll come right here and tell you. See, our wall, we got walls. We still have spiritual walls. See, we got to start building on the walls that we're allowed to have it been hit and penetrated. I come right here to tell you. You say, preacher, how do I build my wall? I'm glad you asked. How do you tell you how you build your wall? Build your prayer life. Be trusting God. Have faith in God. Oh, come on, somebody. Stand on the word of God. Learn how to be a true tiger. Learn how to deal without we preaching on it. Come on. Dwell in Psalms 133 means to take residence, to abide, to continue, to live together. If you read John 13:34, it said, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another as I love you, that you also love one another. By this will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. See, a lot of people don't have true love anymore for each other. Oh, come on, somebody. I come down there soon. Come on, I get out of the pool. See, when we start getting the love that God first showed, the Bible says he showed love before he said it. See, I'm not hung up on how many times you tell me. I'm hung up on how many times you show me. I told my wife that when she first married me, you ain't got to never tell me you love me. But if I see you cooking at 11 o'clock, come on, somebody. If I see you put my favorite shoes on layaway, that tells me a lot. If I see my pocket low and I ain't got to really look at you and I can say my check short, you say, yeah, I'm affected, baby. I'm glad you asked. John 3:16 said, for what? For God so loved the world. He did what? He gave. Stop right now. He gave. He gave. He gave. He gave. He didn't say it. He gave. His only begotten who? Son. Oh, come on, somebody. That you may have a right, that I may have a right to the tree of life. You have to thank God that you're saved by grace. You have to thank God that when you mess up, you got a redeemer that you can go to. Jesus, when you mess up and flock the cast, you may be like Job, when you say, though he slay me, yet shall I trust him? I may have a lump on the side, come on somebody, I may have a tumor cell on the inside, but I'm going to trust God in spite of. We got to get back to the unity, saints. True unity requires being on one accord with one mind. Acts chapter 2, preacher. That's where I'm getting it from. The Bible says there was in the upper room. And it had fully come. that it was all on one accord,
yeah,
with one mind.
Uh-huh.
But the beautiful person I like that God used the most, it was somebody like me, Peter.
Uh-huh.
I'm so glad that he called for Peter. See, I can relate to Peter. See, I ain't start crying in place. I got a few wrinkles in you. You see the nice suit, yeah. But I've been through some stuff.
Yeah.
But Peter was the one that was chosen to preach on the day of Pentecost.
Yeah.
It was the same Peter that denied Jesus three times.
Yeah.
It was the same Peter that ate with the Jews and criticized the Gentiles.
Yeah.
It was the same Peter that ate with the Gentiles and criticized the Jews. Come on, somebody. You're not fucking the church with masks on. But if we learn how to take the masks off and go back and say, I'm going to go get Peter and we come to church. So many people now, they say people leaving the church because people in the church ain't right. Because if that was so, that would nullify John chapter 6, verse 16. Oh, I'm give you a Bible. You're going to get some Bible. The Bible said Jesus asked the 12. He went back to the original 12. He said, would thou go away also? Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. See, they were walking with us. They were walking with the literal Jesus in the flesh. And they left Jesus. The Bible says, see, called 70. And they came back with a good report. Jesus said, don't just glorify me because you cast not devils in my name, but glorify because your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. Even though they departed, but their name was still written. See, Jesus didn't write them off. See, some of them wrote Jesus off, but he didn't write us off. The Bible said he stood in the gap for us. He said, he even told Peter, he said, Simon Peter, Satan has desired to assist you as weak. But I pray for you. It's hard to receive the results of unity.
Amen.
Thinking divided.
Yes.
And being self-centered.
Uh-huh. That's right.
The book of Amos summed it up real good. The Bible said in Amos 3:3, he says, can't two walk together except they be agreed. See, some folk can't walk with you because they ain't on one accord with you. See, that's why some people, you just gonna have to learn how to leave behind. Some people, you just gonna have to learn how to just disassociate yourself with it. Cut yourself off from it. And just say, I'm not rolling with you anymore. I'm not hanging out with you anymore. The reason why I'm not hanging out with you is because I don't know who you connected to, but that spirit that you connected to is starting to get connected to me. And I'm going to church, but I'm not receiving the growth that I could receive. I'm praying, but it seems like my prayer has been answered. And then the Bible told me in 2 Corinthians 6 and 17, now do what? Come out from amongst them and be ye separated, saith the Lord. Sense. You got some people in the church trying to compromise with the world. See, they want to try to hang with the world folks. And then coming to the church, we want to jump them up a little bit. The thing that's going to cut the mustard. The thing that's going to cast all them devils out. Turn it off. I remember them mothers. See, I'm from the old school. I remember them mothers. I used to see them. I didn't know what they were doing, but I know what they're doing now. I used to see them. They'd get down on the altar. And they, boy, they were connected with Christ. They could get a ring of prayer. They'd get down there. They'd get the famine on the floor.